the green here at Laguna. The Toyota Grand Prix of Laguna Seca is underway.
Looks like Miguel Duhamel got a great start. Russell's right on his tail. But look at the number two, Jamie James. Coming back off that injury doesn't seem to hamper his starts, and he's right up there with the front runners.
And way back in the middle, you'll see the number 23 of Doug Poland, way back around 10th position. Unbelievable. Again, he gets a terrible spot, and already a challenge for the lead.
Yes, that's Scott Russell taking the lead over Miguel Duhamel. If he can get a clear approach into the corkscrew, he can put some distance on the rest of these guys, Ralph.
And if there's anything you want to do here at Laguna Seca is get away from the field. Russell, Duhamel, and Jamie James. 1, 2, and 3 as we head our way up the hill for the first time.
You know, Ralph, Russell looked at the qualifying times before this event, and it's so tight, he knows he's got to get down to business early in this race if he's going to be a factor for the win.
If you want to see something beautiful in beautiful Monterey, California, and what a great battle for third. Doug Poland on the Fast by Ferracci, bike number 23, the big red Italian bike, closing in on Jamie James' number 2 Yamaha.
We got two riders here, Ralph. Jamie, I think he's have to ride hard to make up for that.
Scott Russell, who so desperately wanted to win in his last race here in the States, now especially at his home racetrack here at Laguna Seca Raceway. And now, can he catch up to Poland? There is Rob Muzzy, the man who's got his bikes running first and third to make his move. He is starting to look inside. There you see him sticking a wheel to the inside, coming out of four. Tries for the drive, gets forced to the inside. Can he get it? No, I don't think so. Whoa. Oh boy, that was close.
Whoa.
That was really close, and I think, yes, Russell goes from third to first. Scott Russell now, hard on the gas, goes from third to first in one turn.
Duhamel plowed the front end, threw Poland off, and there you go, Russell making up the time.
The picture for you, Scott Russell, your leader on bike number one, the reigning AMA champ. Miguel Duhamel out of Canada on the other Muzzy Kawasaki, sits second on bike 17. Not maybe for long, and challenging from third, the reigning two-time World Superbike champ, Doug Poland on the Fast by Ferracci Ducati, the red bike number 23.
Duhamel and Poland, they're getting in a paint swapping match here. Russell takes another look behind him.
Oh, look at this move. Here comes Poland. Poland tucked to the inside and got one. I thought he was gonna get them both.
A little bit of tire slippage out of there too. I think some of that oil is not being burned on the pipe anymore, and it's making it to the rear tire, Ralph.
That's gonna make that problem compound itself for Doug Poland. He got around Duhamel. Now, can he get Russell? I think, boy, this is really gonna be a hard victory to wrench away from Scott Russell.
I think it's gonna be hard for Miguel Duhamel at this point in time with that oil spraying up. It doesn't take long to get a mist over your windscreen. Looked like Duhamel slipping a little bit of the front end there going into turn six.
Now you're riding with Poland as we head to the corkscrew. This ought to be good.
Russell gets a little bit stronger drive out of the
corner. And he's trying to square it off a little bit.
Yeah, Doug Poland's not satisfied to be in second place right now. He's trying everything he can to take the lead. And there he goes, right under Russell. Russell has to stand up a little bit.
Oh, and he comes right back.
Back
Scott
on the gas.
Russell squares it back off and dives inside of him.
Yeah, see what I told you, Ralph? He'll just come right across your front wheel.
Boy, this is truly some precision flying. You've got to have all your senses working at optimum levels when you're going to battle these kinds of riders in such close competition. And I wouldn't throw Duhamel out of this yet. Whoa, look at the high speed wobbles out of Russell's bike. Poland tries to close it, turn six. Got him. This is the last lap, and Poland drifts wide. Russell goes to the inside, but look at Duhamel. Duhamel goes to the outside. He'll take second, can't get first as Poland shuts the door.
These guys are saving their manners for the victory circle, Ralph. This is an all-out dash for the flag here. Great race.
Oh, boy, here we go. Down the hill, and oh, look at Duhamel go right inside on Poland. Got squeezed off, and now Russell moves to second. One last big shot for the two Kawasakis will come in turn 11. Can they close and make a run at Poland? Russell goes as deep as he can, but I don't think they're gonna catch him. The big red Ducati wins it here in Laguna.
What a ride for Poland. That's two in a row here for Poland at Laguna Seca.
Charms whenever I want to. All I have to do is dream.
Yeah, take a look at the motorcycle, of course.
Most of it, and you know, just a great, great race. I'm real happy to be there.
Three guys could have won this one. It was a great race. I mean, I'm in the presence, and you know, I think we're three of the best superbike riders in the world at this very moment.
That's for his track record pole run. His dream. Champion in the Superbike division out of Sanibel, Florida, the Yoshimura Suzuki of Thomas Stevens.
Tony didn't go very well for us, but coming into this race, the Team Suzuki people have been working real hard to give me what I need to run up front, and I think that you'll see that this weekend. Everyone else is kind of...